The next we are going to learn about what are the commercial use of microorganisms. So in this here we are learning about what are the uses of microorganisms or useful microorganisms. So commercially they are very useful. Let us see. Microorganisms are used for the large scale production of alcohol, wine and acetic acid. I told it is also known as vinegar. Yeast is used for commercial production of alcohol and wine. For this purpose, yeast is grown on natural sugars present in grains like barley, wheat, rice, and crushed fruit juice, etc. So how we will make all these alcohol, wine, acetic acid, etc. So we'll take a little yeast. We will put this yeast into some natural sugars. You know what is meant by natural sugar, which is present, or carbohydrate, which is present in all the grains like barley, wheat, rice, or crushed fruit juice. All this contains carbohydrate or sugars, natural sugars. So we will add little yeast into this. It turned into alcohol, wine, acetic acid, etc. Clear? The process of conversion of sugar into alcohol is known as fermentation. So what is meant by fermentation? The conversion of sugar into alcohol or carbohydrate, that is called sugar. The conversion of sugar into alcohol is known as fermentation. Louis Pasteur discovered fermentation in 1857. So who discovered fermentation? Louis Pasteur discovered fermentation in 1857. That is the commercial use of microorganisms. The next, medicinal use of microorganisms. So we can produce many antibiotics. In the beginning I told we can produce many antibiotics from the microorganisms. Okay, that is a medicinal use of microorganisms. Whenever you fall ill, the doctor may give you some antibiotic tablets, capsules, or injections such as of penicillin. Okay, this is very common, penicillin injection you would have taken. So it's an antibiotic, right? So this antibiotic, from where we are getting from these microbes or microorganisms. So they will give this antibiotic sometime in the form of tablets or capsules or injections. The source of these medicines is microorganisms. So what is the source of this medicine? It is microorganisms. Such medicines are called antibiotics. They are called antibiotics. These days, a number of antibiotics are being produced from bacteria and fungi. So for different diseases, when we go to doctor will prescribe antibiotics. So that is produced from different types of bacteria and fungi. Streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin are some of the commonly known antibiotics. So these are very common antibiotics we will use. We will take in our daily life sometime when we get sick. Streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin are some of the commonly known antibiotics. These medicines kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms. So why we are getting disease? Because any bacteria or virus, it will enter into the body. We will be getting diseases. So when we take these antibiotics, it kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microorganisms. The next is precautions while administering antibiotics. Okay, we should take some precautions. We should be very careful while taking antibiotics. First one is, it is important to remember that antibiotics should be taken only on the advice of a qualified doctor. So sometime when we get fever, we'll have crocin. So it is not an antibiotic, but whenever you take antibiotics without the prescription of doctor, you cannot take that. You have to take only on the advice of qualified doctor. Also, you must finish the course prescribed by the doctor. If you take antibiotics, so that will happen sometime. Doctor will prescribe for 5 days. Some people will take only 3 days. They will forget sometime. So it's no use. Sometime they will skip the tablet. Sometime one day they will eat. Second day they forgot. Again, third day they will take antibiotics. Then no use. So that's the reason telling you must finish the course prescribed by the doctor. If you take antibiotics when not needed or in wrong doses, it may make the drug less effective when you might need it in future. Clear. So if you are taking the antibiotics, suppose it is not needed actually, if you are taking antibiotics when not needed or in wrong dose, what will happen? It may make the drug less effective when you might need it in future. Clear. Also, antibiotics taken unnecessarily may kill the beneficial bacteria in the body. So there are many other bacteria that are present in the body. They are, some are very beneficial. Suppose some bacteria which helps for digestion. So if you are keep on taking this antibiotics unnecessarily, you are taking, you think. So what will happen? It may kill the beneficial bacteria in the body. So you should not take unnecessarily this antibiotics. Clear? So antibiotics taken unnecessarily may kill the beneficial bacteria in the body. Antibiotics, however, are not effective against cold and flu, as these are caused by viruses. So if you are getting any cold or flu, if you are taking antibiotics also, they are not effective. Why? Because this cold and flu, these are caused by what? These are caused by viruses. So antibiotics usually we will use for the disease which is caused by the infected by the bacteria. Clear? So because antibiotics only fight bacteria and not viruses, they are usually ineffective against colds. Sometimes a cold may lead to a bacterial infection. Sometimes cold will start, but it leads to a bacterial infection. In that case, antibiotics would have a benefit if they were able to prevent that kind of infection. Clear? So mainly antibiotics will use only mainly for the bacterial infection. They are not effective for other diseases which are caused by viruses. Then, next one is penicillin. I told just now, penicillin is an antibiotics. It is produced from penicillium. Penicillium means it's a fungus. It's a fungus or it's a fungi. Clear? What is the story behind that? Who invented, who discovered this? In 1929, Alexander Fleming was working on a culture of disease-causing bacteria. Suddenly, he found the spores of a little green mold in one of his culture plates. He observed that the presence of the mold prevented the growth of bacteria. In fact, it also killed many of these bacteria. From this, the mold penicillin was prepared. Clear? So what Alexander Fleming actually, he was working on a culture of disease-causing bacteria. In which year? In 1929. What is the scientist's name? Alexander Fleming. He was working on a culture of disease-causing bacteria. Suddenly, what he noticed? He found a spores of a little green mold. You could see some green mold in one of his culture plates. Then what he observed? He observed that the presence of this mold, it prevented the growth of bacteria. And also it killed many of these bacteria. So then he found out, okay, this mold can kill this. Excuse me. Can kill this bacteria. Then what is that mold? Actually, it was a fungus. Fungus, which fungus? Penicillium. So from that penicillium, what he started to produce penicillin antibiotics. Clear? It also killed many of these bacteria. From this, the mold penicillin was prepared. So that is the story behind this. Then what is meant by vaccines? So sometime when you are small, most of the children, they will go and take vaccinations. So what vaccine means? Nothing but, so any bacteria or virus, it will enter into the body. They are called antigens. Our immune system, it produces antibodies to kill that particular antigen. Clear? So vaccines means what they are injecting? They are injecting dead or weakened microbes. One example I'll tell you, chickenpox vaccine, you think. Okay, you did not get chickenpox. You are going and taking the chickenpox vaccination. What they will inject? They will inject dead or weak chickenpox virus into the body. Then what our body will do? Body will start to produce antibody to kill that particular chickenpox virus. Clear? Then body will produce the antibodies and it will kill the virus. So the next time, now the antibodies are remaining in the body. It's ready to kill. So second time, the chickenpox virus will enter into the body. You are getting chickenpox, you think. By the time body is ready, antibodies are ready to kill that particular virus and it kills. That is called vaccines or vaccinations. So vaccine means nothing but what they are injecting. They are injecting dead or weakened microbes. Clear? When a disease carrying microbes enters our body, the body produces antibodies to fight the invader. The body also remembers how to fight the microbe if it enters again. So if dead or weakened microbes are introduced in a healthy body, the body fights and kills them by producing suitable antibodies. That's the reason just now I told, they are injecting dead or weakened microbes, body will produce antibodies. The antibodies remain in the body and we are protected from the disease causing microbes. So next time the same virus will enter, body is ready to kill that virus. Clear. This is how a vaccine works. Several diseases including cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox and hepatitis can be prevented by vaccination. Clear. So we are taking vaccinations for all these diseases, cholera, tuberculosis, smallpox, hepatitis, etc. Children are given injections to protect themselves against several diseases. Necessary vaccines are available in hospitals. Vaccinations are given to children for protection against polio under pulse polio programs. You know what is in my pulse polio programs? It will come in newspaper in the same day people are coming even the home to home. Even we can go to the hospital, parents will be carrying the children and they will go to the hospitals. They will give polio drops. This polio drops given to children are actually a vaccine. So what is that polio drops means? It's actually a vaccine. This is called oral vaccination. Okay. So, but they are giving inside the, they are giving in mouth. So they are called oral vaccination. These days vaccines are made on a large scale from microorganisms to protect humans and other animals from several diseases. So these days we are producing different types of vaccines from microorganisms in large scale. From microorganisms to protect humans, animals from different and also plants from different types of diseases. So nowadays, this pandemic time, you know, there is a coronavirus. So we did not find out the medicine or vaccine for this. Okay. So it is actually, it's a respiratory, it will affect the respiratory system. This virus will affect the respiratory system. So scientists, they are trying to find out the medicine for this virus or vaccination for this virus. The next use of microorganism, it increasing soil fertility. Some bacteria and blue-green algae. Blue-green, there are different types of algae. And that one type, it is blue-green algae. They are able to fix nitrogen from the atmosphere to enrich soil with the nitrogen and increase its fertility. These microbes are commonly called biological nitrogen fixers. Okay, so there are some bacteria and blue-green algae. How they will help? They will help the, you know, the atmosphere which contains, there is a mixture of gases are present in the atmosphere. So they fix nitrogen from the atmosphere into the soil and it makes the soil very fertile. So what is the use of this nitrogen in the soil? It is used by the plant for its growth. Okay, nitrogen is very essential for the plants for its growth. So who will be helping here? The bacteria and blue-green algae, etc. With the nitrogen and increase, what they will do? They fix nitrogen from the atmosphere to enrich soil with nitrogen and increase its fertility, soil fertility. These microbes are commonly what it is called biological nitrogen fixers. Okay, you can see in the figure. The next one is the last use of the microbes, cleaning the environment that you people know. So any plant or animal or human, they will die. Where they will go? They will go to the soil. After a few days, you can see that they will decompose and it mixes with the soil. So our body, which contains all the nutrients, okay, carbohydrates, proteins, then minerals, then vitamins, everything is present in the body. The person, the human or animal or plant, anything will die. It will go to soil and after a few days, it decomposes. Why it decomposes? Because with the help of microbes or microorganisms. Clear? Otherwise, there is a pile of dead bodies. So it helps us cleaning the environment. It decomposes and mixes with the soil. And this, again, it is used by the plant. Plant will absorb from the soil. Okay, and it is used for the growth of the plant. And also it produces fruits and vegetables. It is eaten by the herbivores. And also herbivores eaten by the carnivores. So we are also eating. So again, it's coming back to us. Clear? It's like a cyclic process. So you often see large amounts of dead organic matter in the form of decaying plants and sometimes dead animals on the ground. You find that they disappear after some time. This is because the microorganisms decompose dead organic waste of plants and animals, converting them into simple substances. These substances are again used by other plants and animals. Thus, microorganisms can be used to degrade the harmful and smelly substances and thereby clean up the environment. So that is another use of microorganisms. So these microbes, they are known as friendly microbes. Why they are called friendly? Because they are very useful to us. or they are useful for humans or animals or plants, they are known as friendly microbes, or these are the uses of microorganisms. Thank you, students.